I'm Tom Gaynor, and I'm from Adelaide, South Australia. I think I realised that I wanted to do comedy when I was maybe about 13 in high school, and I just started saying horrible things to other kids in the class and the teacher and making people cry, and I got a tremendous thrill out of that. I entered Raw last year and changed my routine once, and it came off really bigoted and horrible, and I kind of bombed really hard, and then I was telling everyone all year, like, yeah, I'm going back hard and I'm going to win. They didn't believe me, and I did it anyway, because that's the type of guy I am.
Up next, this proud Adelaidean sells records by day and pizza by night. Please welcome Tom Gaynor.
That's what it sounds like when doves cry. I've got a dad. When I was young, he said to me, Tom, what do you want to be when you grow up? Luckily, I had the foresight to say, a deadbeat stoner. Then he said, Tom, you can be anything you want to be when you grow up. And I said, that's not true. I can't be a child star. I have a mom. She's a police officer. She gave me a lie detector test. I think I beat it because I just answered maybe to every question. She has an angelic singing voice. I wake up to it every morning. I can't remember the tune of the song right now, but I think it's called Get Out of Bed Right Now, I'm Very Ashamed of You. She buys a lot of carrots for the family. She says they'll help us to see in the dark. I just think if she spent less money on carrots, we'd have some more money to buy light bulbs every now and again. She called me up today and she said, Tom, how did you spend this day? And I said, I stood outside of court hoping to see one of those people with the blurry heads. I have two life dreams. One of them is to go into the middle of a city in China and open up an everywhere else town. The other one is to open up a homosexually inclined refreshment stand at a horse racing track and call it Gay Waterhouse. I met a woman, we went out on a date, and I do what I always do on dates, which is wait until about halfway through when everything's going really well, then hold her hand, look in her eyes and say, I've killed before and I'll do it again. But things weren't going so good, I wanted to break it off. So I asked my friend how best to break up with this woman. He said, just treat it like a band-aid. So I forgot all about it, and a couple of weeks later I saw her float past me in a public pool. Thank you and good night.